And I got a very, very, very special guest, Super Paul. So we're going to be doing some grappling, some wrestling. And first of all, we're doing this every 7 p.m. Every day that we're closed, I'm considering doing it once a week anyway because it's awesome. We're having a good time. Saturday at 12 o'clock as well. I see you guys commenting. I can't answer your questions. I'm not that fancy. Okay, so Super Paul's going to start with some basic wrestling takedowns. We're going to start with them wrestling style, with wrestling style setups. But then later on, we're going to move it into self-defense, how to do it without the knee on the ground, how to blast through people, smash them on the floor, and have a good time. So Super Teddy and Super Paul, we'll go through our basic double legs.
All right, guys, so we're going to start with the basic double leg takedown. We'll talk through the setup, we'll go through the details of it, and we'll finish the move. So for my double leg takedown, right, I want to always have inside control. So what that means is I'm coming in between, on the inside of my opponent's arms, and I can either have my grip, monkey grip on the triceps, so I can have a collar tie, which is preferable, right? I always control my opponent's head. So from my inside control position, all right, my basic setup, all I'm going to do is I'm going to snap my opponent down, right? Once I snap him down, his natural instinct is going to be to pop up. Once he pops back up, he just opened up that shot for me, right? So once my opponent comes up, I take my shot, my lead foot is going to land right in between his legs, and I take my double leg. Now, hence the name double leg, I'm wrapping my hands around both of his legs and around both of his hips. And I'm locking my hands right by his hips, right here, and I'm squeezing nice and tight so that he can't sprawl. Once I take away his sprawl, he has no defense there, right? So I'm just going to have Super Teddy turn this way, so we can see from here, right? I snap my opponent down, he comes up, opens up my shot for me, take my double leg, notice my head comes all the way through, and it's on the side of his ribs. I'm locking my hands around both legs, right around his hips, and now I'm set up to finish it. So from here, the way I'm going to finish it is I'm going to run this all the way to the side. So I'm going to use all my tools, right? I'm going to drive off my leg here. I'm going to use my head to drive into his ribs, and I'm going to block his hips. So from here, I step up, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run this to the side. All right, I'm going to do it again. From my inside tie, right, I'm going to snap my opponent down, he's going to come up, I take my shot, my head goes all the way through, and it's up on the ribs, good posture, right? Let's turn this way so everybody can see from this angle. Look at my posture here, right, my back is straight, my hips are in, and my driving leg is up here, right? I don't want to see anybody doing this, you have no posture here, you have no power, you're never going to finish this. So I want everybody to make sure they have good posture from here. Once I have this locked up, I'm going to step up with my down leg. I'm here, and then I'm going to use all my tools to drive my opponent towards the side. So we'll show it a couple times in live action so you guys can see what it looks like. All right, so from here, snap down, comes up. And one more time. All right, inside control, I snap my opponent down, he comes up. There's my shot, and I drive, and I come.
Awesome. So what we're going to do now is we're going to show this from a different kind of setup, different kind of position, more self-defense, Jeet Kune Do style, where the knee will not come on the mat. So first off, let's talk about the stance in which is conducive to hit this double leg. So if Super Paul's a bad guy, his stance is a little bit squared. His fist is a little squared, his right foot's in front of his left, and he's squared. Now squared to me. If I can get that pillar up, bang, 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 that guard up, lower my level, I'm in, and he's gonna get finished, right? So again, I don't need that penetration step this way every time. Sometimes I just lower my level and I just run. Sometimes I lower my level, I connect my hands in a more technical way. I connect my hands, lift, and he's gone, right? So let's do a couple of easy combinations. We'll do the entry and not the finish. So, jab, cross, hook, step through, connect, hips are in, and we're finished, right? So we're here. Jab, cross, hook, and we're finishing, right? Nice, tight, and technical. Straighten up with the hook. Same thing, finishing, right? If I just duck a jab, I'm in on that double again. Even better, I duck it,
high crotch is better. But the hips are square. I catch that hook. And he's with me. My hips are in. He's with me. This is what you would see in like a real fighter, like MMA, where from being up here, it's super hard to go heel, toe, knee, step, drive. When you're in a wrestling stance, look at the wrestling stance. Versus a fighting stance. So much difference. So when I'm up here and he gets down, bang! Yeah, those wrestling skills come out still because he's in his hips. Oh yeah, opa. Right? So, if I'm staggered, see the JKD stance is a good stance for takedown defense because, and the wrestlers can talk about this because we're not square. This is what he wants. When I'm staggered, he has to get one leg and then he's gonna get bumped, hip's gonna come down. So if I am staggered on offense, he has to go high crotch. So if you look at that this way, one arm goes through, cuts it off, then that arm comes, he's gonna finish, right? Because again, my feet are staggered. Yeah, so if a guy fires a jab at you and you're in the same lead, the right hip comes forward and you're right in on that high crotch, no knee on the mat. That's a major difference between real fighting, street fighting, takedowns, and jiu-jitsu, wrestling, and more competition-based. You're not on a mat, and you're in a different fighting position, which doesn't eliminate the knee on the floor, but it makes it less good, less accurate, less powerful, right? So a big thing is getting those hips low, he's in on the shot, he cuts it off, and he finishes, right, big time. So now, think about this though. If when you're in there in wrestling, he's got to clear my ties, right? In real fighting, as I throw, he dips. He doesn't have to clear anything. He's just getting me in transition. And that's what's important. If you're going to work your shots in transition, let's go, I'm left lead now. I fire a big right hand, he's going to go double leg. Bang! Yeah, he's going to take me because my weight now is square, what the wrestler wants. Old school takedown stuff. I fire your hips. Oh yeah. Big John, when you're thrown on the concrete like that, it is not friendly, it is not nice, and it does a lot of damage. If you're gonna wrestle, you slam the guy big time. So, you know, when you're looking at your takedowns, come to the wrestling class, wrestle in Brooklyn on Saturdays, 2 o'clock. Wednesdays, 8 o'clock in Astoria, and we're gonna probably do a Saturday class in Astoria soon too, but either way, come and you'll learn the fundamentals, you'll be able to add it to your striking. So now, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna talk about the guys in opposite lead and a way to grab the single leg without putting your knee on the mat, which is called a snatch. So if my arms are nice and high here, like a traditional striker, and Stephen Paul's on the left lead, he lowers that level, gets his head in my ribs, now he snatches the single, and he works whatever finish he likes. Nice and easy, right? So Ted, come back. Let's just drill that a few times and go through the details.
Yeah. So what's happening here is Simpson's gonna be lefty, right? He's gonna throw a jab with that lead hand. And what's happening is I'm slipping the jab, and while keeping my neck nice and strong, that's the key here. I don't wanna drop my head and pop my head in. I'm always keeping my neck nice and strong, and it's my forehead that's going right in my opponent's ribs, okay? And what I'm doing here, especially if you're looking at a traditional JKD guy, their weight is gonna be on their front foot. So by doing this, when I slip the jab, I lower my level, my forehead's going right in his ribs, and what that does is that pushes him back a little bit, and that takes the weight off that front foot. It makes him rock back just a little bit, and it makes it a little easier for me to pick that leg up, right? So, see, the take goes the jab, I drop my level, forehead right in the ribs, and as I drive forward, I'm just snatching that leg up. And what's happening now is I'm pinching that leg in between my legs. Because my main focus here is I have to keep this leg straight. Sifu Teddy's defense here is to bend this leg. So what he wants to do is bend that leg, get it to the outside, now I'm in a little bit of trouble. So my job is to keep this leg as straight as possible at all times. Because he has no balance here and he's weaker. So while keeping this leg pinched between my legs, what I'm going to do is I'm going to step out to the outside, catch the leg, scoop it, and I can finish it. And we'll do it the other way so everybody can see. exactly what's going on. So, Steve Buteti throws the jab. I lower my level. Notice that my neck is nice and strong and a good posture. My forehead's going to go right in the ribs, knock him off his weight, off his balance, and I pick the leg up. So his leg is now pinched between my legs, and I'm also holding onto with my hands here. Notice my head didn't move. My head's staying where it is because I want to keep the pressure on. So the way I keep this leg straight is as I remove my inside leg, I'm going to catch his ankle with my hand on that same side. So I'm doing this. All right? Same exact time because I have to keep this leg straight. So as I remove this inside leg, my hand is here to catch his ankle. No space there. From here, again, keeping in mind that I have to keep this leg straight the whole time, I'm going to bump with my knee and then switch off and scoop the leg. From here, I want to elevate his leg as high as possible. So I'm going to touch my hand to my ear and walk him down. Okay, one more time. So, Steve Buteti throws the jab, drop my level, foreheads up, right into the ribs, snatch the leg up, I'm pinching it between my legs, then it's going to be my inside leg that's removing itself, and I'm going to catch it with my inside hand, right there. Then from here, I'm going to bump it, scoop it, and then from here, I'm touching my ear, and I'm raising my elbow to the side. And I walk my hand down and I make sure I have my control. Again, the reason why this all works is because I kept his leg straight. As soon as he bends his leg, all this goes out the window and I have to adjust. So that's why it's very important. Those little steps, those little transitions, catching the ankle, bumping it, they're very important because you have to keep your opponent's leg straight.
Cool. So we're gonna definitely get back to some wrestling and some grappling in general, some foul tactics and takedown defense later. Let's kind of brush up on some basic striking, and we're gonna put it all together in a second. So I'm gonna take you two guys here, right? So first things first is just having good front hand action, right? Mixing in the jab with the straight lead, with the footwork, and just manipulating distance ever so slightly, right? So let's start with the first basic drill. It's gonna have your fighting position, feet shoulder width apart. Take a healthy step forward with your dominant side. I'm gonna right you, so my front toe's gonna line right up to that back heel. My head's over my pelvis. Back hand's gonna stay high. We're at range now, so my lead hand is pointed right at the bad guy, right? So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna inch in on a jab, fire a long straight, circle, circle. Right, so real basic, but very neat circle, circle. Now my hand's pumping. Look, I go jab, hand comes halfway back, then straight leads half, half. I'm sacrificing a little bit of thrusting power with my arm to get there a little bit faster. So when I'm here, just give me one time. I'm just gonna go nice and slow to the first. Jab, straight, circle, circle. Right, one more time, slow. Jab, straight, circle, circle. A little faster. I'm just making my way around the corner. So you guys just that point for a minute. You go twice for everybody watching. Good, circle, good. Okay, just circling around the corner, firing this stuff. Yeah, one time. Yeah, good, circling, circling. Good combo. One more. Good. So now, sometimes we go straight lead first, then we go jab, and we're gonna go overhand. Now we throw the overhand, elbow's gonna come over the hand. We're gonna go straight lead, jab, overhand. And of course, overhand's a big power shot, but it's gotta be set up with the straight shot, so it's gonna go straight lead, jab, bang, over the top. This blow is high. Straight lead, jab, overhand. Right, nice and slow. Straight lead, jab, overhand. And I'm walking him down with the straight shots, setting him up with that big bomb over the top and trying to put him out. Slow. Straight lead, jab, overhand. Right? So you guys go for a few seconds. Two for two. Over. Straight, jab, over. Good, one more. And switch. Over, there it is. Nice. Oh, there it is. Yes. Good. So let's
We're going to tie it back to wrestling. We're going to put some level changes in our combinations, right? So sometimes I get my way in close, and I weave my way, or I slip my way into body shots, right? So, you know, I'm going to demo it first, and then see what type of live action. So imagine I throw two jabs at him, and that pillar comes up, pop, pop. Now watch, I'm going to go body, body, and I'm going to scoop both sides really nasty. So I come straight here. Body, body. So he's gonna do that with me. We're gonna go pop, pop, body, body. Yeah, nice and nasty. Pop, bang, bang, yeah. Again. Good, again. These are good habits. He's rolling under. Because same type of action is gonna happen when I jab. He slips. And now he's in on that double leg or the body shot. So he fires one and now he's in on the double. Because those are the types of actions that you have to set up if you want to take the guy down. It's getting him used to you seeing dipping, slipping. So now if we're here on the pillar, I'm leaning on him, boom, quick level change, and I'm in, right? I'm already there. I worked my way into my striking. Wrestling for striking and real fighting is different than wrestling for wrestling. All the best MMA guys will tell you, listen to Daniel Cormier. It'll be like, there's some guys, you put wrestling boots on them, and then you take down everybody. Then you look at George St. Pierre, and he could take it down in the wrestling room, but doesn't in real fighting. Big difference, right? Because he's comfortable mixing in his striking with whatever his favorite takedowns are. So let's stick to these dipping style hand combinations, we'll call them, and then we're gonna tie that into the wrestling and the grappling in a second. So now watch. Next one is just basic, right? I feint upstairs and come with a low jab. Bam. Feint there. Now that looks drastically similar to double leg, right? It's exactly the same. It's the same motion. Feint hit, feint hit, feint, boom, he thinks I'm hitting and now I'm in on that double leg. It's just being able to blend your striking with your grappling. And that's what a good Jiu Jitsu practitioner does. See, JKD guys were doing MMA or MMAS things. What I mean by that is mixing in striking and grappling way before it became cool. And then the MMA guys came and started doing it as well. But at the same time, wrestlers, specifically wrestlers, lead with their dominant foot, right, Stephen Paul?
Yes.
So it's an easy transition if you're a wrestler out there to go from the way we strike into wrestling because you're going to lead with your dominant side. And you can go get a greater volume, a greater variety of punches with your lead hand, lead foot. It keeps you safer whenever you throw the rear hand, exposes the center line to takedowns and, of course, striking as well. But we have to throw that as well, right? Now, the other thing is, when you're in there, it's about keeping the motion small. Another thing, right, if I make a small little dip, small little dip, pop, those uppercuts come real hard, so I go fake, bang, and if I get him dropping his level and putting his hands down wrestling style, boom, boom, I'm knocking him out with those little level changes. So sometimes a wrestler, they'll lower their level with you, and open up their hands to stop. Well, can you show it for me? Like, he's worried about me shooting. I lower my level, he opens up. So now watch, I feint it. Fuck, I'm sorry. Sorry, bang, right under, over the top. Feint under, fuck, over the top. So you hear guys talking about using the uppercuts to counter the wrestler some of the more. But there's a lot of ways to do it. A lot of times there's feinting them out with the wrestler's own stuff, which is a shot. So if I'm here, he's not gonna just sprawl when I lower my level. He's gonna lower his own first. And then the boxing can come right off of that, and that's how you catch guys. You ever hear the term, you get knocked out by the shots you don't see? Well, that's exactly a good example of it. You go from striking to wrestling mode, boom, your neck comes up, those shots start putting you down and out. So let's kind of continue on with those dipping, slipping style actions, right? We're here. Let's say we're in the pocket. I dip, and I fire an uppercut, right? So you're here. I dip, fire an uppercut. Next time I dip, and I'm in on the shot. That same little transition. I dip under the guard. So we're here, we're shot, dip under the guard. Now next time I dip, and I'm in on that double. Of how you can mix the striking with the grappling if you decide to take the guy down. And if you do, you need to know what to do when you're down there, right? So another motion before we go live back with the wrestling is just ducking and weaving. And instead of using it to strike, or only to strike, we're going to use it to get it on the leg, so it's the right forward. If I weave, I'm in on that high crotch, just the way Stephen Paul just showed. So I duck, catch the leg, then I'm right into that high crotch entry. So let's just get a couple of those live. Okay, we can just duck it on there. Oh yeah. Run.
Oh yeah. And what's happening here, guys, is he's throwing the strike. I'm weaving, I'm ducking, and I'm taking what he's giving me, right? That's going to be the main difference when you're looking at what kind of takedown you're doing. Whether you're doing a double leg, a high crotch, you're looking at what kind of stance your opponent's in and what he's giving you. In this stand, in this case, he contends in a Jeet Kune stand, so he's going to be a little staggered, he's a little bladed, he's giving me his lead hip. So in that case, he throws that strike, I weave, that lead hip is right there, I'm going to take my high crotch, right? That means I'm just attacking that lead leg first, and then from there, I can finish it however I want. I can finish it with a double leg, I can finish it running the pipe, I can finish it a lot of different ways, but at the end of the day, I'm taking what he's giving me. So we always have to keep that in mind, right? You can have what you want in your mind, but you have to take what your opponent gives you. So here, right, he throws a strike, I weave, I'm going to take that high crotch, and I'm going to finish it with a double leg. One more time, right, he throws it, I weave, high crotch, cutting it off to the double leg.
Awesome. So, let's do this. Emmanuel, come on, you take your gloves off. Just drill it into some wrestling stuff. So what we're gonna do is no impact, right? Emmanuel's 15, he's super tough, but you'll see that wrestling can be drilled super safe. As long as you're not slamming the takedowns and being nasty about it, we're gonna do about 45 seconds to a minute of just wrestling drilling that gets you these good habits that when you get in, you'll be able to finish. So just
basic wrestling drilling, nothing too high
out of the takedowns.
Takedown.
Go ahead.
So we'll start with a simple duck under, right? I want to have my inside control, right? Collar tied here. Inside control, monkey grip on the tricep. All I'm going to do here is I'm going to elevate the elbow just a little bit. I don't need much. Create a little wiggle for myself. And then with my lead foot, I'm going to step to the outside. And I'm ducking my head underneath. And as I do that, I'm just spiraling my opponent to the ground right here. And there, we're using all momentum, right? I'm using my body weight, dragging my opponent to the mat. Not really muscling anything here. So here, create a little window for myself, stepping to the outside. As I do that, I'm passing by the arm, and then I'm just spiraling it down to the mat. So I'm using my momentum, my weight, and a spiralized motion to bring my opponent to the mat. One more time here, full speed, right over here. Right there. We can also take that duck under and stay on our feet. Right? We can use it to take our opponents back, to lift, to do a variety. Right? I can slip the jab, step in, and I'm here, and now I just lock the arm. Right? And I can use that to lift, take his back, whatever I want to do from here. So one more time, he throws the jab, I slip it, and I'm just going to step in, and what's happening is I'm trapping the neck and the arm here with my head, and if you notice, I'm pinching my head nice and tight. I can do a lot of different things from there. Right? But it all comes off that slip. And if you notice, I'm keeping it nice and tight. So he slips, and I continue that. So as I step in, there's no space here for the duck under. Right? I don't want to be here. I don't want to be wide open here. I can lock it up. Right? I can lift in the crotch. I can do a lot of different things. So that is off the jab. Or I can even do the way we set it up before, where I had that inside tie, right, the collar tie, and the monkey grip on the tricep. And as I step through, instead of bringing it to the mat, right, let's say we're trying to apply this maybe to the street or self-defense, right, maybe I don't want to put my knee in the mat, right? So all I'm going to do here is I step to the outside, I change my level, and then I'm exploding back up. And now I'm here, I'm in that same position. Okay, so we can use that kind of defensively slipping a punch, or I can set that up on my own if I want to grab it. So here, I have that inside collar tie. Right? I'm going to create a little window for myself, step to the outside. Right? It's very important that that lead leg steps to the outside because I want to create that angle on his hip. So I step to the outside, lower my level, and as I come up, I just explode up and I'm using my momentum there. And now you see I have his hip, I have the ankle, I can take his back from here. I can do a lot of different things from there.
Awesome. So, as you see, guys, grappling can't just be like this very stagnant, like here's one position, here's another position. You have to be able to go from move to move and keep it realistic within like street fighting or self-defense context, which is where you want to go. But we're big believers in get the fundamentals, learn how to shoot a double, right? Learn how to hit a high punch, learn how to defend a single leg, hit a single leg, deal with a body lock, do a body lock. And then when you enter into these transitions, they're a lot easier, right? So now what we're going to do is we're going to do a fun little counter So when the guy single legs you, I'm going to keep the streak. So he grabs this single leg, right? So the first thing I want to do is push his head and get control. The next thing is, if I can get this far wrist, if you see this hand, the wrist on the top, I start pushing inside and getting my leg out. Now from here, look, I can post an elbow, cross kick, donkey kick it out, switch to my rear naked choke, and I'm shutting the wrestler down street style. Because I don't want to get into a wrestling exchange with a guy that's a better wrestler. I want to stop this thing right away. Boom! My head's here. Bang! I catch this wrist. Head's low. Shin is across. Even without this wrist, the shin is across. And now from here, the finishes for single pull are a lot harder because he's got to let go. Right? So watch. Push, elbow. Push, elbow. Cross face is number two. Right? Smashing. Pushing down. You're literally stuffing the head down. Old school Greek moonsault. Just bang right to the face. Right there, donkey kick. And from here, bang, just getting into him, striking style. You know, again, a guy collar ties you, old school, you just grab him, throw him, punch him right over the top. Like, old school street stuff. Like, because if I start getting into this collar tie, he's going to get, he's too strong. But again, you just come right up and under and lift his face up, old school, right? Guy goes, bang, popping off and firing, just shrugging, stepping, looking, old school, like, same Russian move, like you go here to a Russian in wrestling, same thing. He grabs, not today, right? Being able to take the collar is nasty. Being able to do it in a way that, again, I'm not going into straight wrestling. Bang, firing. So the detail here is, he's grabbing my neck, I shrug, I got him wrong. Make the letter L, step, pop it. He's gonna get hit with that left hand. Another cool one is, he gets the collar tie, right? I have this. And I start swimming in, and I get the overhook, headbutt, just literally D-block and headbutt, because he needs this arm to finish any takedown. He's not going to be able to finish another head right there. Catch it. Boom. Just old school stuff. You got to be able to strike within the clinch. But before you strike in the clinch, if you notice, we're going to start with striking, because if you get fancy and you just think, oh, I'm just going to do this, you need the control first. Everything in grappling is control. He gets an underhook and whizzes it hard, right? Now I'm stuffing him, trying to catch him, getting my head control. Hips away, bang, hitting the wrestler with things that he doesn't like. He wants to be here. He wants to be here. He's gonna have a million finishes from here. But watch, he's here, just take it off, bang, just smash it. Like, you know, whizzing that thing hard, hitting his head, we're fighting for this inside out, and just de-blocking it here. Head goes through, push, bang. Couple of knees to the liver changes everything, right? Couple of knees right to the face, again, changes everything. Pushing, elbowing, but nothing crazy. No loose grips, no standing upright, no letting him just get his head underneath you and just smashing you. Everything's strong, right? You need a little bit of that play time in the clinch, and it's super easy. You just play, and it becomes a lot easier, right? So, just give me 1 second, I'm gonna get my gloves on, Teddy. Come with me, we're gonna go some more striking. So, in line now with kind of like funky combos, we're gonna do like a little quick switch series where, yeah, like we're here and we're close, but we're gonna switch our feet on the entries, right? Really nasty. So, shout out to Super Taiwan, he's doing this like the best of them. It's like a quick switch for kicks, but the hands just come off different angles and then all sorts of nasty stuff is going to come right behind it. So all of this, I'm going to hold for Super Teddy. He's going to hit that quick switch and cross. Bang, there it is. Good. See, push it. So first one, he's zigging this way, then he's zagging that way, and he's both of these shots have power. So you get guys and gals that say, well, you need to plant your feet to hit hard. That's wrong. Clear as day. Look, smash it. I don't know, I don't want to get hit like that, and I've been training my whole life, I don't know about you. But you get smashed in the face like that with the momentum coming your way, no good. Next addition, switch, bang, firing the low kick as the last one. And just the way you go jab, lead, leg, it's cross kick, not cross retract kick. Cross kick. One last detail, when you fire that low kick, spaghetti leg it, leg comes up, bang, shin down, big drop. Right? So he goes here, bang, bang, low kick over the top, chopping. Opa, let's go. Opa, that's it. Again, there it is. Again, good. One more. Very good. Now we're gonna play with a fancy one. Open step. One more cross, right? So I'm touching the kick. Bang, 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 pop. One more cross right after. So slow. Pop, 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 pop. I can finish off with that hook. So nice and slow. Open step, bang, bang. Just like that. Nice, again. Nice, again. Good, one more. Nice, right? So you see these little open steps, they have a lot of utility, right? Off of this, you got your momentum going. Bad, bad, bad stuff. Another common one that you can do is, now he leaves, right? So I open step, he leaves. Straight leading him. Just catching him in transition up that straight lead. So look at the feet. I switch, then I'm going double straight lead right after him. So let's hit that one touch. Nice. Switch step. Nice. Again, let's hit the feet slow. So after the first one, I left. The ability to open and close distance, we talked about yesterday in the streaming class, like today. If you can open and close the distance at will, you have a major, major, major advantage. Major advantage. Because you're mobile. They talk about sparring Bruce Lee was like trying to catch a cat in a little room, but every time you got close to the cat, it had a hammer. Well, that's a tough opponent because the movement is on point, the power is on point, and it's a very safe style. If you let the guy right in front of you, you have a problem, because if the guy can exchange better than you can, you have a pretty big problem. If you're able to hit and move, move and hit like this, enter and exit on your terms, big problem. Big, big, big problem, right? So now, right, we're gonna talk about stepping back off of these combos, right? So I go double jab, cross, and I'm gonna step back on the hook. So I'm coming in real basic. And I'm gonna step right back up. So see, because I'm gonna go double jab, cross, pop, pop, cross, I step back, bang, he's hitting me with the check hook. Pop, 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 check hook, beautiful. Check hook, again, pop, 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 check hook, one more. Good, now, remember our forward, 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 forward. We step back on that check hook, what's an even better exit here? Sliding, getting right back to position. If you wanna get real fancy, slide into the cross hook, right? So, look at my legs. I went hook. My weight's on my left leg, right? Slide, land right into that next cross hook. So let's do that one slow. Hook, slide, cross hook. So right as his left leg is landing, that cross is starting, right? So hook. So people go, you can't hit hard while you're moving. Look, pay attention. Look at the rhythm of it. Shot. Nice. Slide on the land. Yeah, just like that. Just like that. Just right on the land. So if you get a dummy that's just chasing you blindly, stepping into you, bang, smashing them, right? Now again, you can curve, which means angle with your punches while hitting with power if you know what you're doing, right? Because think of this. Your head is over your pelvis. You're driving off that foot, and you're getting all that whip and centripetal force around it, so a curving hook, hard. Yeah, there it is. Curving, bend, right around the corner. Good, that's arguably as hard or harder as if you went completely stationary. One more time. It's actually harder on the curve step in this case, right? Because it's getting that whip action correctly around the corner, so don't let your footwork hinder you. Let it be a place of opportunity where you can use it to generate more force, create a new angle, create new opportunities, and re-attack in whatever you deem fit. Because watch. He goes curve step, straight leg. That footwork, right? You came around the corner. And this is perfect if you are in opposite lead. Look, I'm going to be left foot forward, he's right foot forward. Comes around my shoulder, and he's stepping right through. Down the bar, stepping right through. And if you notice, that second shot was a straight lead. It was a vertical fist. The shoulders are turning. This shoulder is almost perfectly lined up with that shoulder. When I push into that,
it's super strong, right? So let's do it again. Bop, bop, beautiful, right? Right around that corner, because again, my left foot's forward, he swings this thing around, and he's catching me. What do they tell you to do? Always rotate away from the guy's power, right? That's textbook. We can talk about going the other way, but not right now. For now, when he's going to that left side, bang! Now watch this. He doesn't make it on the first one, double curve. Bop, bop, just like that. Sorry, we're both straight after that. Bop, bop, really, yeah. One more time, fast. Bop, bop, bang. So in real time, look, he's circling, circling, then hitting me. I'm turning, turning, turning. I either have to give up the real estate and he's gonna come after me, or I turn into a shot. Again, we're big here in New York Martial Arts Academy at moving the feet while you're throwing the punches and kicks. Keeps you way, 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 way more dangerous. Just a shameless self-promotion. Every single night, 7 o'clock to 8 o'clock, class, live streaming. Until we reopen, I'm probably going to do it once a week. And then Saturday, 12 to 1. So come in. Instagram, YouTube, live, right? So just come in. We're going to have a good time. Now, let's get back to work. Again, those angles, super, 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 super important, right? If you're able to angle, then step out of the way now, and then recounter. So he steps out of the way, or slips into it. Then steps out of the way, fires over the top. So he curves, slips, body, head, whatever, right? Just nasty. Then fires over the top. Yeah. Again, then those angles. And you see he's continuing his motion, right? He's getting greedy for that angle, which is what he's supposed to do. If he starts making his angle real tight this way, and he keeps going that way, forget my left leg. He's already scored. He's already all over me. If he stands right here, right in front of me, he's got to deal with everything. If he gets this angle here, no question, right? No question. Watch this solo much angle in boxing, the best angles in the business, right? If you don't think angles work, watch. He's doing it to everybody live. He's hand trapping. He's doing all sorts of things that guys don't understand. And by the way, he's leading with his dominant side. He's a righty. Look at his stance. At range, he's like this. Lee shoulder high, hands covering center line. Firing jabs, moving the head, moving the feet, switch stepping, doing all sorts of stuff that look like the Matrix, right? But it works. What's he doing? Footwork with head movement with great tools. You go, you're not Lomachenko. Be like, yeah, I get it. I'm not Lomachenko, but the principles still remain, right? See, you're not Bruce Lee. You can't do a sidekick. Of course you can. It's mechanics. It's time. And if you train on the floor, why wouldn't you be able to do it? It's like learning to shoot a basketball. If you spend enough time doing it, you're going to get good. Every move works in the right context with the right person doing it with the right timing, right? So again, if you just look at the right way to move, it's mechanics. It's physics. There's no arguing it. The right strategy, the right tactic at the wrong time, that's more personal. That's like, are you more of an aggressive person? Are you more of a counter striker? That depends on who you are. But from a mechanics standpoint, hitting and moving, moving and hitting is not a good strategy. It just works when your feet are moving in conjunction with your tools. Right? So with that, let's just go, Tevi, get a kicking shield. We're gonna demo some kicks now, but you can keep the gloves on. We're gonna probably still hit a little bit, right? So now let's see if you get the guy frozen a little bit. Like, we'll demo it a few times. Like, you know, everybody does it off of the roundhouse kick as the finish, right? So now let's say I finish with a cross, I'm gonna step out and I'm gonna hit that inside low kick, or bang, right up to the body. And see, Teddy's really good at flipping this up to the head. So we're gonna start on that left side, off of the cross, roundhouse kick to the right. Yeah. Bang. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. One more. Good job. One more. Good. Now the next one, he's gonna carry the hook. So he's gonna go cross. Step with the hook, fire the low kick. So this one's real sneaky because if you're stepping in on the cross, out on the hook, then finishing the low kick. So look at the feet. Left cross, right hook, only the left leg, then the kick comes right behind it. Super nasty. Right? Same thing that we see. Oh yeah. Shin. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Nice job. Again. Very good. One more. Good. Now, another cool one. He fires that cross. I step back. That front kick just comes right behind him. Pokes. So that pillar comes up. I'm going to do it to you. Pillar comes up. Back. And he just poke it right through the middle. So cross into left trachea. Oh yeah, right there. Nasty. And those don't feel good, believe me. Yeah. Nice. Good. There it is. Okay. Fun one is off of that little sidestep. So again, I go hook, sidestep, side kicking the knee on the sidestep. So hook, sidestepping right into the kneecap. If the guy's wobbly a little bit, his leg is too straight, one, two of these really change the fight big time. Let me see side kick to the knee. Other way to. There it is. Go. Oh, yeah. His hips are too square. So now I start with the lead hand, right? I can go jab step with the right foot, enter in, or slide with that right foot, bang, and just pull it. Pull it right up to the groin. So it's a simple pencil match that you learn day one in Jeet Kune Do, coupled with an upwards front kick. If you've been here, you know what you're looking at. Make sure you're selling that first feint. You're selling that bridge. And coming up, piddles to his belly button. Just literally groin to his belly button. Nice and easy up the middle a few times. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Nice job. Good. Oh yeah. One more. Very good. Very good. So, you know, you look at these kicks, and again, you look at it on the pads, you go, what's he hitting? He's hitting the groin. Street style. Because one of the things that makes Jeet Kune Do so different is, yes, of course, we're technical. We try to work our body mechanics every single step of the way. However, we have to keep it real and keep it for a self-defense context. Hitting the groin, hitting the knee, gouging the eyes, in close, headbutts, right? All the bad stuff coupled with the super technical stuff is what makes Jeet Kune Do so dangerous martial art, and the practitioners, when they're good at it, very vicious. Because if you put your hands on me, well, I'm not just gonna start wrestling with you, put my thumb in here, I'm gonna headbutt you, I'm gonna elbow you. If I throw you on the floor, I'm gonna start smashing you, not just jujitsu, you know, working my hold, even though I did jujitsu and won the competition and all that stuff. Like, I don't want that. I wanna be on top just literally smashing and dominating every step of the way. That's why we love wrestling, right? Make martial arts, you know, great wrestling guys, because look at the UFC. Most of the champions, 4 out of 5 of them, I think, are come from a grappling, but specifically not grappling, specifically a wrestling background. Because it gets guys to be where they want to be. If I want to stay up, I don't let you take me down with my wrestling. If I want to put you down, I put you down with my takedowns. Couple that with awesome footwork and striking and mixing it in with the holds and the takedowns and submissions in the ground and pound becomes super, super dangerous. And that's why this takes a little bit of time, because there's a lot to the art. There's outside fighting with the footwork, you're working good stuff. There's infighting where you have to be able to wrestle and grapple a little bit. There's infighting where you're unattached, and you have to know a little bit on the ground, especially like how to scramble and get back up, defend the takedowns, and do a few if you know how. Right? So, JKD is an all-encompassing martial art. So, especially on the streaming videos, the streaming classes, we're going to try to hit different stuff. Striking, wrestling, and now we're going to get back to the clinch, right? But we're going to do it from more of a striker's perspective, right? So, we're here, right? Yesterday we did more of the elbows and the headbutts and the upper body stuff. Now we're going to go through the mechanics on the knees and maybe how to exit. So, when I grab this tie clinch, it's one on top of the other, and if Supertetti goes to look up here, he's going to have a really hard time, right? One on top of the other, collars are down. Now I'm on my toes. When I want a knee, I'm on my toes. So one leg goes back and it just knees in. Knees in. Knees in. Now look, my heel can also come backwards and around the corner and try to go through the middle. Those things hurt. They'll come up to the face, they'll concave your chest, they'll break your ribs. Left side, try to turn this and bang, hit the liver. right? Even just like simple stuff like stepping through and kneeing, which we're gonna get to in a second, just opening him up from a striker's perspective is really interesting, because if you grab the guy, you might control the strike, you might control the grapple, today we're controlling the strike, right? So look, I'm here, I'm gonna take my foot, I'm gonna put it like a butterfly hook, I'm gonna step through on one more big knee, right? So we're here, I have that tie cruise, my head's gonna be up, it should be down, but I'm gonna talk to you guys. Step, bang, and then I'm back to skipping, elbowing, switching, all the stuff that I know how to do and just putting it in combination, right? Now, you get that tie clinch, right? And sometimes the guy goes over your throat, like they try to go like over the top here. So it's going to like a little slide by in wrestling. You're gonna fake, you're gonna go one knee, and we're gonna go right here. Same position we were in, instead of the claw, we're gonna pin, look at this way. Oh, sorry, let's go this way. I'm on the tie clinch, I throw one, lower my level C grip right here, one quick move. Bam, head up. Teddy, is it easy to move here?
Very hard.
Very hard, right? So I'm turning him down. Now look, knees are gonna come from the right side. From the right side. He's gonna fight out of this. But I'm gonna get 2-3 free knees into the liver. Very, very nasty. You could also do it from here. And we're here. Bang, and I'm turning him in the direction that I wanna meet. Right? So when I get it, I'm turning him into the way I wanna meet. And getting his momentum down to open up that liver, right? Most righties will duck with a right hand collar tie. Right hand is on the collar, left hand is here. Pinching, right? Now, if he just squares up to me, then he's gonna get, if I know my takedowns, I'm gonna take him down. So I'm gonna switch from striking to straight up wrestling if I know what I'm doing, right? And these transitions are vicious, they're dangerous, right? Another time, elbow city. Elbows. He looks up here. Headbutt city. In the eyes. Back to elbowing, right? Even just like he puts his hands on my hips, I just step him back and come right to the middle. That's not going to stop anything. Right? He goes here. He stops the first one. Step both hips back. Right down the middle. He's in trouble. Now, guys go, what if you're in with a wrestler? And he grabs this knee. I go, get a knee. That's where you're going to be able to just get back here. Head control. And get right back to that single leg defense we were talking about at the beginning of class, because it all ties together. I don't know what this guy's gonna do to me once he starts getting a little desperate. Gets hit with a couple elbows, headbutts, knees. He's gonna dive on your legs, right? But when? How? Sometimes the guy gets desperate, he eats a knee and he grabs it anyway, or he just dives on it. That's why you need to be able to wizard. That's why you need that single leg defense. Couple of wrestling class. Saturday, Brooklyn, Wednesday, story. Right? So again, just to tie it all together, you don't want to be a boxer. You don't want to be a kickboxer. You don't want to be a wrestler. You don't want to be a jiu-jitsu guy. You want to be a jiu-jitsu person that's able to put it all together seamlessly. No hitch in your game. No hitch. You're able to move. You're able to strike. Guy goes to take you down. You have good hips, good hand fighting. Way to get back up, because I don't want to be on my back in the street. If I end up on my back, I'll show you a bunch of ways to get back up and threaten with submissions, but we're going to do everything we can to avoid being on our back in the street, avoid the ground if possible, but if we were going to pick one wrestling out, wrestling. It's without a kimono or a gi, which is the way most people fight. There's a lot of takedowns in it, which you won't see in some other grappling rounds. I won't name them to bash them, but a lot of takedowns, a lot of takedown defense, and it's the original hand-to-hand combat, ancient Greece, right? So, let's just end up, right, with just some cool footwork, right? We're here, let's do some half beat. I want to really leave now. So now I'm playing the runner. I'm the guy that wants to point fight and just get in and out. Watch this. We're going to go slide, step, push back. So a lot of times you'll slide, you'll land, then you'll get out of the way of a punch. We're going to put it together where we take out one of the motions. So my left leg, it never lands. So the second part of the move. So you're just marrying the slide, step, and the push off the back. You're here, slide, push. Slide, push. Oh, and for the last 5 minutes, I'll let some time for questions. You know, bear with me, I'm not so tech savvy, so I might like turn and look at it, but we'll finish up with 5 more minutes of forward, 5 minutes of questions, and we'll bow. Let's go. Slide, push. Slide, push. Now just reverse it. Push, slide. Don't land the front foot now. So instead of landing the front foot, then sliding, push, slide, you know? And, you know, you'll see it because the Gipino footwork is very simple, but it's like you're supposed to do it like there's a piece of paper underneath your feet. And you're supposed to be able to inch away towards angle, manipulating distance, manipulating space, every single step of the way, because if you do that, you're going to win. If you're the one opening and closing distance on your terms, you're going to win. Why wouldn't you work your forward? You give me a good reason why you wouldn't work your forward. And then you can think about it. Work it. It's not as interesting as like straight up battling it out, at least watching it and learning it. But when you get it, you're able to battle it out when you want. You're able to shuck, jive, and move as you being fit as well. It's ultimate freedom. People say, oh, wrestling's ultimate freedom. Sorry, Paul. Footwork's ultimate freedom. Because footwork gets you to your wrestling. Footwork gets you to your striking. Footwork gets you away from your wrestling, gets you away from striking if you want to. So when I look at it, real simple. If you're able to move and hit and you have good grappling, you're super dangerous hand-to-hand. Later on, you gotta able to add the weapon, the knife, the blunt object as well, because that's part of self-defense, which we're probably gonna do on another day. But from hand-to-hand stuff, striking and footwork first and foremost, defensive grappling second, and just knowing your way around there third, right? So let's just do one or two more footwork, and we'll leave a few minutes for questions, right? So let's review what we did before. We did that little switch, open step into the cross, right? Switch, open step into the cross. Yesterday, we went backward stepping with power. What's the key on that one? Dropping, and shifting the head. Look, slippery fish. Right? Head shifting on that first cross, shifting on that second cross, banging them on that third hook. Right? You see stuff like this? Again, just simple curve steps. Not a step and a pivot and a hook. Driving off the back with tiny curve, right? Working your way around the corner, JPV, moving ever so subtle to create these tiny little micro angles which keep you safe, right? Again, you're here, straightly drop stepping, pivoting off of the cross. We did that one yesterday again. Jab cross, drop step cross. Jab, straightly drop step cross, right? All that stuff. And again, just the head and the feet in motion, slipping, dipping, getting fancy if you want. But good old shadow boxing is going to get you where you want to go, especially when it comes to footwork and movement. Another basic one, again, I'm stepping back to hit. Half step on the cross, half step on the hook. Half step cross, half step hook. Half step cross, half step hook. Bang, bang, just like that. Being dangerous on those angles, right? Like stepping off, not this way, not back, out on that angle, off that uppercut. So guy fires and they're stepping in. Uppercut, cross, and changing the trajectory of my angles mid-combination. Again, super dangerous. So we're going to leave some time, 4 or 5 minutes for questions. So I'm going to go to Instagram first. So any questions? I'll wait for your questions. But yeah, guys, it's been super fun teaching you guys. You know, keep them up. Keep the questions coming about today or anything else, anything you want to see. So like I said, I'm going to leave a couple minutes for comments.
You too.
Why is JKD? That's a great question. So JKD is the best martial art in the entire world because it encompasses all aspects of combat. Kicking, punching, elbowing, knee, trapping, dropping the weapon. It has a physics element to it. So from a mechanics standpoint, you learn the proper ways to throw your punches and kicks. Super important, because if you don't have the proper ways to throw your punches and kicks back by science, you're wasting your time. Number three, it gives you personal expression. I might be a more counter-fighter type guy, and Sikutani might be more aggressive, and the art gives me the tools, the strategies, the tactics to be able to do that within my own being, with who I am. I could be a really good counter-fighter, a super aggressive guy, all within the same art. The striking is super technical, the footwork is second to none, which gives me my threat between the kicking, punching, trapping, grappling, and the weapon, and everything is technical through and through, while, and this is important, while keeping a self-defense mindset. There's a lot of super technical kickboxers and boxers that don't really look at self-defense, and there's a lot of untechnical self-defense guys and gals that only look at the foul tactics. We look at both, so you can smash people. Next.
Any other questions? That was a good one, Isaac. These so awesome, basically. Again, any other ones? I'll finish it up. I had a great, let's see. The drop step, yeah, sure. I can definitely demonstrate the drop step. So it's called different things, and we call this the drop step. So I'm in fighting position here, front toe to back heel. And let's say I fire across, right? My weight's on my right leg. I drop step out, right? Sometimes people call this a drop step, and you can know really this is a drop step, drop shift. So Teddy, come here for a second. If we're shift out here and I turn, look, my toes are facing Teddy, his toes are facing this way. So I'm gonna go fast, 1-2, that angling. I'm creating an angle while being dangerous. It's a good example of Jeet forward that hits off of the angles and creates new opportunities. Good question.
Drop step, okay, cool.
Any other last questions? Because one more and we're gonna go. Ding. Okay guys, if there's no more, I had a super, super, super fun time with you guys. Again, tomorrow, 7 to 8 p.m. And then the day after, and then Saturday, 12 to 1, we're gonna be doing these classes online. I hope you guys have a great time. I know we're having a blast, right guys?
Yep.
Super awesome. You guys are awesome, and have a great night.